Thank you, Eddie, and cannot wait to see you in person soon, inshallah, in Riyadh. So it's my great pleasure to be with you here in Riyadh today with our distinguished guest, the engineer Nasser Al Nasser, who is the CEO of STC. STC do not need any introduction, but before diving inside the today's session topic, I would like first to thank and to congratulate Dr. Abdullah on our behalf, the president of SADAIA. Thank you for having us today, and congratulations for the amazing achievement of yesterday. 13,000 people registered, a peak of 7,000 together watching the program. This is what I was told by the organizers. From 150 countries, definitely, the AI Summit is really global. Congratulations, and congratulations for all the MOUs. Thank you very much, Your Excellency. So, STC, just for the people who are watching us, is a company that you should absolutely visit when you come to Saudi Arabia. I had the privilege to visit a company which is already at the top of the innovation. And I mean it. You have a smart building headquarter. I was jealous of having your autonomous vehicle bringing people from one building to another building. Sustainability is the core of your strategy. And you are definitely writing the future and the future of sustainability. So as we heard yesterday, Engineer Al Nasser, the world is definitely experiencing now currently an acceleration of AI. And STC is one of the top corporations, as you know, in the kingdom, leading this innovation, as we just mentioned, and the future. So what are the strategic implications of this acceleration for a large national companies like STC?
Okay, thank you very much, Richard. And thanks to Professor Abdullah and the team for inviting me. It's a pleasure and a privilege to be in this global AI summit. First of all, we have to look at AI from two perspectives, from the enablement part and from the potential and the use cases part. So if I start with the enablement part, as a large corporate and as an ICT company entrenched in the digital transformation, I believe there are many foundations. And usually people confuse when we say AI, people may refer to the technology itself, you know, GPUs, clusters, nodes, etc., or the whole ecosystem. And globally, I believe the successful countries are the ones who are treating the AI as an ecosystem, whether it's from the public-private partnership, the use of the right funds, the regulation frameworks. One of the most important issues related to AI, and that's, I believe, the advancement in AI, is not only hinging on the progression of the computing power, etc. It's the data. And how the proliferation of data is happening today, you can collect data from anything, anywhere, everywhere in the world. As a telecom operator, the amount of data is just unbelievable that we collect from customers. And I believe this data is a plus, and you can do magic with data. Yet it might be a curse if you don't follow the regulatory framework, if you don't have the right data governance, if you don't maintain the privacy, if you don't have the right cybersecurity mechanisms. So there are pillars that need to be in place to make sure that you position yourself as an AI company or digital transformative company. I talked about the regulation, and it's very important, the privacy of data, the cybersecurity, the technology itself. You cannot assume an AI without the right technologies in place. When I talk about technology, cloud, I believe 5G. With its capability, coupled with edge computing.
So you are a strong believer on 5G.
I strong believer in 5G, not as an incremental in terms of bandwidth or only latency. If you look at the potential of network slicing, at the potential of multi-access edge computing, coupled with AI, I believe there will be a magic as a use case is done from the 5G. So infrastructure. And if I go a little bit deeper on the infrastructure itself, in Saudi Arabia, we used to rank 3 years ago 105 on the global speeds. Today, alhamdulillah, we beat it number 5 globally as global speeds. So having the basic infrastructure that lend itself so that you can do the applications, you can collect the data with low latency, then you start actioning the data, you take the insights, you correlate the data, you have the data sets, then you action the data, is a must. You cannot assume a digital transformation or implementing AI without having the right technology and right framework in place. One of the most important point is the reskilling of people. If you look at WEF, WEF is expecting 73 million jobs will be displaced by AI by 2022. It's 2 years from now. It's not something that's deep in the time. Yet it's expected to have 130 million, unless there is the right conducive environment for training people, for reskilling, for education. I'll just give you one example that testimony the how our government is putting, investing in education at the top priority. A 1 billion riyal has been granted to university in 2019 just to help transforming the education. As a company, we have started for the first time, and I believe one of the few companies that has started hiring based on skill, not only based on education. And we just started that program. I am a big believer that it will. Honestly, we've seen calibers in the cybersecurity that have never gone to university, and they are excellent. So we are designing ourselves to make sure that we pave the way for this one. We have also a cooperation with the universities. Today, we have a chair with King Saud University, specifically for the AI research and development and use cases. So I believe you have to look at it as an ecosystem, and one of the most important pillars, Richard, of that ecosystem is the partnership. Partnership with technology provider, partnership with industries, it's very important. We have a partnership with Philips regarding the telehealth. I don't think that any technology company will be able to deliver an AI without a partnership with the relevant verticals and complementing their technology, their cloud, their data scientists with the know-how, and it's a strategy refresh, it's a business refresh more than anything else.
With the passion you have, Nasser, can you please help me to kill this cliche, which is AI will kill jobs? You are talking with passion about people.
Yes.
And even I would like to quote you, if you allow me, recently you said, you have even affirmed that STC seeks to develop AI to enrich people's life.
Yes.
Can we talk about this notion of jobs destruction and also how AI more precisely will enrich people, our lives?
There will be an impact for AI on the low-end tedious jobs. I believe, I'll give you just an example of what we've done in STC. We have something called alarm correlation and failed orders. That every day, before end of the day, we have an army of people, they go into different systems. We have a complex IT system, and that's the telco. You have an issues with some of the pending orders that you need to clear manually. Today we developed a machine learning and AI algorithm that the pending orders go automatically to zero. It replaced, you know, that army of people that waiting by the end of the day to make sure that there is, you did not send an activation for a service, but it also created another jobs. And that's a testimony of WIF when they mention around double. But you cannot create that opportunity unless you have the conducive environment for learning. We have today a special track for data scientists and AI in our specialized development program. So I believe it's coupled together. Yes, it will kill jobs if you take it as an absolute, but it will create another jobs once you have the environment conducive and the investment in the education, the investment in reskilling of people, and that's what we are doing internally as a company. For the other part of your question, I'll just give an example of what happened during the pandemic. Countries, alhamdulillah, we are one of them, that has been handling the data, have been able to isolate the infected cases, have been able to take an immediate decisions on where is the curfew, what not to curfew, and what to let loose in terms of mobility of people. And this is one of the advantages. First of all, you have to have the right data, and you have to have the right governance out of that data. You have to have the right insights and the right actions. And we cannot do it as a technology company. We've been working with the Ministry of Health, and Saudi Arabia has done well, alhamdulillah, in that regard. And I've seen it globally that all countries that have been able to deal with the pandemic and isolation of the infected cases, have deployed the data analytics, have deployed the right AI algorithms, and I believe what we have seen today is only the tip of the iceberg. We will see much, much more in the future from use cases. And telehealth is one of the most prominent examples that we've deployed cameras, you know, what do they call? They call them the heat cameras.
Heat camera, yeah.
With an AI algorithm in coordination with Philips, that added a lot of value so that you can have the insights. Again, you need
analyze.
You need fast internet. You need all what it takes to make sure that the infrastructure, you need the right cloud, you need the right latency. But these use cases will just get more with time. And we are only scratching the surface in terms of use cases for the AI.
Dear Nasser, time is flying, but I would like to ask you a very important question at the kingdom dimension. His Excellency Dr. Abdullah yesterday launched the national, I would say, AI strategy for the kingdom. Very ambitious strategy. So what is your hope for the kingdom of Saudi Arabia? And what can international partners, as you mentioned, do to help precisely the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia to succeed in this national strategy?
Well, for the first part, inshallah, it's not a hope, it's a belief that we will achieve much more than, you know, than any other countries in the world in terms of development of the AI, in terms of investing in skills. We have a very, you know, young population. We have Hemmah Jabal Tweeg. I don't know how to translate this one. You know, there is Jabal mountain, a big mountain that we have, you know, the same strength of that mountain. So I believe with this one, we will overachieve with the support of the government, sponsorship, and this summit and the establishment of Sadaya itself is a testimony of what we need. I believe for the partnership, we will not be able to dispense without the right partners. And across the ecosystem. And we expect the partners to invest in terms of funds, of know-how, in the localization, and to reap the benefit of their investment. It is, I believe, a win-win situation.
Thank you. And so fantastic. Thank you very much, dear Nasser. And allow me to thank you, and to congratulate you.
Thank you.
First, I would like to congratulate you because this virtual platform will not be able to happen and to exist without the fantastic STC network. We have to say that, you know. At the end of the day, this digital world is thanks to you, the telecom operator, and I have to say that your network is really fantastic. And thank you with my second hat, which is as the FII Institute. You are a very pioneer partner, strategic partner of FII from day one. I would like to thank you for
that. Thank you,
ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.